When you're recording a comment on a video in VoiceThread, you can actually insert your comment into the timeline of the video. This allows you to draw attention to a specific point in that video, and it allows your participants to see exactly where you were when you began recording your comment. To get started, just drag the scrubber ball to the portion of the video where you'd like to insert your comment. Click on the commenting button, and click on the type of comment you'd like to record. The very first time you use this feature, you'll get a tooltip telling you how to use it. If you don't want to see this reminder again, just check the box that says "Don't show me this anymore." Or if you do want to see this again, just drag the scrubber ball to a different portion of the video and then drop it. Now VoiceThread is recording my voice. Don't forget to annotate on the screen as you record, or even navigate to other portions of the video as you record your comment. When you're all done, click Stop Recording, wait for your comment to process, and then click Save. Your comment will process on the left-hand side for a short time, and you'll also see that down where you began recording your comment, there's now a small blue nib that represents where you were when you began recording. This is how other people can find your comment within the video's timeline. If we come to a slide where several people have already recorded comments, you can see those comments represented by the small blue nibs along the timeline of the video. In addition, when you hover your mouse over the video's timeline, you can see those comments represented in this small pop-up. In this way, you can see several different representations of the conversation. You have the chronological view down the left-hand side of the VoiceThread, just like you would with any other type of slide, or you can come down to the bottom and see the comments represented in the order in which they appear in the video's timeline. Here we can see that Ray recorded his comment at the 1 minute and 19 second mark within the video. And if we hover over that nib, we see Ray's name highlighted as well. When you hover over each nib, you can see whose comment that is by the highlight within the pop-up. You can even click on a person's name to begin playing their comment. When their comment begins playing, the video jumps to the portion where they were when they began recording so that you can see their annotations and the portion of the video that they interacted with as they recorded.